Welcome to lecture 23 on stochastic processes. Today I am going to discuss continuous time Markov chain, which is also known as Markov jump process. So consider a continuous time stochastic process, say x t, t greater than or equal to 0, that means our time domain is from 0 to infinity, which is a continuous set, with a discrete state space S. So discrete means it can be finite or it can be infinite state space, that means countable. So we consider a continuous time stochastic process xt with a discrete state space. So you can say that it has discrete state space and continuous time domain. So we say that the process xt, t greater than or equal to 0, is a continuous time Markov chain. In short, CTMC, or it is also known as Markov jump process. If it satisfies the following condition, what is that condition? For any sequence of real numbers satisfying zero less than or equal to t naught less than t 1 less than dot 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 less than t n less than t n plus 1, the probability that x t n plus 1 is I n plus 1, given that x t naught is I naught, x t 1 is I 1, dot dot dot, x t n is I n. And this is same as probability that xt xt n plus 1 is equals to I n plus 1, given that xt n is equals to I n, where these I naught, I 1 and I n, I n plus 1, all of them belongs to state space S. Okay. So what it says? It says that this conditional probability, that probability that x t n plus 1 is I n plus 1, given that all these things. So if you see, this is just the Markov property. Why? Because it says that, see, we know that the state at time t naught, we know that at t1 and tn, and we want to predict future. But this probability is only depending upon the current state. If we call it tn as current time and t0, t1, all of them are past. So your future only depends upon the current. So this is a this is the Markov property basically. So I am writing this Markov property in continuous case. So this can also be written as, remember that this must be true for every sequence t0, t1, tn, and tn plus 1. So we can write down it equivalently for all s t greater than or equal to 0 and I j x u belongs to state space where u is in between 0 and s, if probability that x t plus s is j, given that x s is I and x u is small x u, where u is in between 0 to s, this probability is equal to probability that x t plus s is equals to j, given that x s is equals to I. So this is the same thing, of course. What we are saying that here we have past, okay, u is lying between 0 to s. So this is your past information, this is your current information, and this is your future information. So it says that probability of future conditioned upon current and past is only depending upon the current. So your future is depending only on the current. So this is again written as this is the Markov property. So both the things are same actually. Both the things are equivalent. We can show that. So this is the Markov property. So what we are saying? We are saying that a chain, a Markov process which has time domain continuous and state space discrete, and it satisfies the Markov property, then this is known as continuous time Markov chain. So I would mention it here. The above condition means these above two conditions actually is known as Markov property. Markov property. Okay. The transition, what it says actually, the transition to state J at time T plus S depends only on the value of the state at the most recent time s. Okay. So what it says that the transition to state J at time t plus s depends only on the value of the state at the most recent time s and does not depend on the history of the process. This is the current and this is your future. So your future only depends upon the current state, not on the history of the process. So that is the standard Markov property. So in most of the cases we take our state space S to be 0, 1, 2, n if it is finite, or 0, 1, 2 up to infinity if it is countable. Then each random variable, then this each random variable xt each random variable xt has an associated probability distribution. I ranges from 0 to infinity, where PIT denotes the probability that XT is equals to I. I can be 0, 1, up to infinity. What it says that since XT represents the state of a process, it is the probability that your state of the process is I. And I can be anything. So, you will have a probability distribution in most of the cases. Now, we can define transition probabilities as we have defined in discrete case. So, define the transition probabilities, P I J S comma T is equals to the conditional probability that X T is equals to J, given that X S is equals to I, and this S is greater than or equal to 0, less than T, less than infinite. And I and J, they are from 0, 1, 2. So, you can see that this transition probability, now we have 2 times S and T, where S is less than T. And we are going from I to J in time S to T. So, this is the transition probability. Now, as we have seen in discrete case, these transition probabilities may depend upon S and T. They may depend upon difference of S and T. So, if they only depend upon T minus S, that means the length of the interval, then we call it stationary or homogeneous probabilities. So, if the transition probabilities, if the transition probabilities do not explicitly do not depend explicitly on S or T, but depend only on the length of the time interval, that is T minus S. Why? Because you are starting at time s and then moving towards j at time t, the interval is t minus s. So if these probabilities pi j s t only depends upon t minus s, they are called stationary or homogeneous. Transition probabilities. And if we have homogeneous transition probabilities, then chain is known as time homogeneous chain. So otherwise means these probabilities depends upon S and T explicitly. So in that case, they are referred to as non-stationary. Non-stationary or non-homogeneous. Okay. So we will only consider the case of homogeneous probability. Here we will consider the homogeneous case only. That means whatever I am going to discuss, I will consider that the probability is also homogeneous. So we will consider the homogeneous case only, and in that case we write Pij t minus s. Instead of writing t comma s comma t, we will write the Pij t minus s, because these probabilities depends upon t minus s, not on s and t separately. So this is the probability that xt is j given that xs is I. Since it is time, it only depends upon t minus s, that means it is not depending upon s and t separately. The same thing can be written as probability that xt minus s is equals to j given that x naught is equals to I. Because in both the cases, see, if you start from s, I, and at time t, you end at j, okay? Then what is the length of the interval? Length of the interval is t minus s, okay? And if you start from 0 to t minus s, I to j, in that case also, the length is t minus s. Length of the interval is t minus s. So, in both the cases, length of the interval is t minus s. So, this probability can be written as Pij t minus s. Or simply, we can write Pij t. Because what is the length? Length of the interval is t minus s. So, instead of writing t minus s, I can write down Pij t is equals to probability that xt is equals to j given that x naught is equals to I, where t is greater than or equal to 0. Okay. So these are the probabilities we define, and they are time homogeneous probabilities. So if they are transition probabilities, so in most of the cases, the transition probabilities the transition probabilities satisfies what they satisfy. Number one, since they are probabilities, they must be non-negative. And second thing is, sum of Pijt, if j ranges from 0 to infinity, this must be 1 for every t greater than or equal to 0. So they must satisfy these two things. Because these are probabilities, they must be non-negative. And if you are leaving state I and going towards state j, so we assume that after leaving state I, you will enter into some state j. So this sum of Pijt must be 1 for every t greater than or equal to 0. Then why I have written miss in most of the cases? Because there are some exceptional cases where this summation condition will not satisfy. There are some exceptional cases. So I will write down that in remark. So there are some exceptional cases known as explosive processes there are some exceptional cases known as explosive processes where the condition summation Pij j from 0 to infinity is equals to 1 does not hold for all t greater than or equal to 0. That means it may hold for some t, but it will not hold for all t. There are some exceptional cases and they are known as explosive processes. I am not going to discuss those processes here. If you are interested, you can search it on Google. But yes, there are cases where this condition will not hold for all t. That is important thing, for all t. It may hold for some t. And the second remark is, that all finite continuous time Markov chains. Finite means the state space is finite. They are non-explosive. That means if your state space is finite, then this condition will always hold. So there are some infinite continuous Markov chain which are explosives. Okay, so this is very important to remember that the second condition may not hold for all t. So these transition probabilities will satisfy the Chapman-Kolmogorov equations as it was the case in discrete time Markov chain. So I will not write down the proof because the proof will be similar, but I will mention it here that these transition probabilities obey the Chapman-Kolmogorov equation. Equations. And what are those equations? Pij t plus s is same as P I K S P K J T and sum over all K belonging to S. And this is for all S and T positive. So recall that what it says. It says if you start from zero time and you are ending at T plus S from I to J. So it says that take a time S in between, and then from at S you may be at state K, and this K will belong to any state. So you are moving from I to K, then K to J. So that is I to K and then K to J. I to K in time S and K to J, remember that this is time homogeneous Markov chain. So it only depends upon the difference. And what is the difference? T plus S minus S. That means the difference is T. So it only depends upon T. Okay. So that is the Chapman-Kolmogorov equation. So the proof is similar. I am not writing the proof here. So the derivation. See the derivation. Of the Chapman-Kolmogorov equations in continuous case is, that means in continuous time, is identical to the derivation in discrete time. So the derivation is similar, so I am not going to derive it here. So if I put this equation in the form of matrix, so in terms of transition matrix PT, which contains elements P, I, J, T, we have P, T is equals, sorry, P, T plus S is equals to P, S times P, T for all S, T greater than 0. So, this equation P I J T plus S is equals to that can be written as this in terms of matrix form. So, as we have seen in discrete case, if we know the transition probabilities and initial distribution, we can find everything. So, here I would mention the same thing. So, if we know the values of the matrix PT and the initial probability distribution, Qi, which is probability that X naught is I, that means process starts in state I. So, if we know this, then for 0 less than T1 less than T2 less than Tn, we have, so what I am writing, I am writing that if we know PT and initial distribution, then we can find all other probabilities. So P X naught is equals to I comma X P1, call it J1, X T2 is J2, and X T N is J N. Okay, that means we want to find the probability that at time 0 the state is in I, at time T1 it is in J1, at time T2 the process is in J2, and at time Tn minus 1 process is in Jn minus 1, and at time Tn it is in Jn. We want to find the probability of this path, that the process is following this path, that at time 0 it is at I, at T1 it is at J1, at T2 it is J2, and so on. So we want to find this probability. So I am not going to write down the details because we have done it many times. Using Markov property, we can easily write down that it is Qi, because you start from state I, then you are moving from state I to J1 in time T1. Okay, so you are moving from I to J1 in time T1. Then you are moving from J1 to J2 in time T2 minus T1. Okay, so next step is you are moving from J1 to J2 in T2 minus T1 time. Similarly, at the last, we are moving from Jn minus 1 to Jn in time Tn minus Tn minus 1. See, at last, time difference is Tn minus Tn minus 1, and we are moving from Jn minus 1 to Jn. So that we can write down using Markov property. So this we are writing using Markov property, because it only depends upon the current, not on the past. So if we take sum over I from 0 to infinite, or I belongs to all state space, then what we will get? So adding over all states I gives us, see, on the left hand side of this equation, if you take sum from I belonging to, for example, S, and you write down probability that X naught is equals to I, X E1 is equals to J1, X E2 is equals to J2, dot dot dot, X Tn is equals to Jn. On the right hand side, we will have I belonging to S, Qi, Pi J1 T1, Pj1 J2 T2 minus T1, and so on. At last, Pjn minus 1 Jn Tn minus Tn minus 1. So what is this? This is, you are starting in state I, and I belonging to S. That means all the possibilities are there. So this will be nothing but probability that T1 is equals to J1, XT2 is equals to J2, and so on. XTn is equals to Jn. So I am using the theorem of total probability. This sum will become this, and on the right hand side we will have the same thing, that this is Qi Pi J1 T1, P J1 J2, T2 minus T1, and p j n minus 1 j n t n minus t n minus 1. So we are getting this one. That means if we know initial distribution and transition probabilities, we can find out distribution of the process of any path. So these are the some analogous things in continuous time Markov chain. You can easily understand that these are similar things as we have done in discrete time Markov chain. Then what will be the difference? We will see the difference in future lectures where these two things differ. So before ending this lecture, I will provide some examples of continuous time Markov chain. For example, Poisson process is continuous time Markov chain. If you focus upon number of accidents at a particular place on a particular day, that will be a continuous time Markov chain, because time domain will be continuous and number of accidents, that may be 0, 1, 2 and so on. So state space will be discrete. So that is continuous time Markov chain. Similarly, you can have a number of claims arriving to an office of insurance company. So that is also continuous time Markov chain. So there are lots of examples of continuous time Markov chain. In next lecture, I will focus upon Poisson process, and we will see the details of Poisson process. So I will stop here, and thank you for watching this video lecture.